Hi, welcome to the Weekly Buzz. I'm Buzz Lagos. Today we're going to analyze a couple plays that occurred in the game against Atlanta last Saturday in Minnesota's 1-0 victory. We'll also look back to the Indy 11 game against Minnesota and see if Minnesota can deal with some of the challenges they'll face when they go to Indianapolis to play their game this coming weekend. Minnesota sustained good pressure throughout the first half. Atlanta's defense was tough, well-organized, tough team to break down. There was a reason they're undefeated and why they've given up so few goals, and Minnesota was challenged by that Atlanta defense. But they kept probing, kept finding the feet of quick players like Jamie Watson, Miguel Ibarra, Khalif Alihassan. All those players helped Minnesota combine in good fashion and break down the defense and eventually led to a goal. See, it starts with just knocking the ball around to Giuliano, a little possession.
Venegas, in for Vicencini. Ahead, Alhassan. Good through ball, Ibarra onside. Ibarra, Campos! Oh, what a beauty!
Now, if you look at a couple things that make this happen. Again, the light possession, but the run by Giuliano in behind the forwards into the midfield area for Minnesota. He's able to just turn and face upfield. A little touch, and he sees Khalif open and turns and looks and notice the diagonal run from Miguel. He's in an onside position. Khalif sees, gets his head up, and Khalif sees not to play the ball into the space to the defender's right, to play it forward into the box. Notice he plays the ball straight, not to Miguel Ibarra's feet, but to the space. Now Miguel's gonna get onto the ball. Defender's thinking he's offside, but you can see clearly he was onside from that central defender. And he runs the ball, gets to the line, and the cutback and the touch, that back heel touch by Pablo Campos to put it in. Now let's watch happens off the ball. We see Pablo Campos starting to run and drawing that defender, central defender back, and the defender's looking at Pablo. He continues on back a little bit, back, and just there he's got a little edge for the defender. He decides to dart forward and makes that run. And notice the ball comes through his legs, and it's just a subtle touch of the right heel. Just knocked that ball in. Just inside the goal, just a wonderful finish by Pablo Campos. So clever. Getting the goal just before halftime is really a great boost of morale to the team, just like it deflates the team if they give up a goal just before halftime and go in the locker room down a goal. But the 1-0 lead is a crucial lead at this time of the season when Minnesota is struggling for victories and they needed the 3 points. And if you can win those 1-0 games, it really can help determine your season for you, actually. And it just takes a lot of tenacity to play tough defense, deny the other team any chance to score goals, and perhaps try to add to your goal, but sometimes it doesn't come, as it didn't come last Saturday. We're into the second half against Atlanta. We have the wind in our face. So Atlanta has the wind advantage, so it's tough for the defense to get the ball cleared. Atlanta's only down a goal, so they have great incentive to push forward and put pressure on Minnesota. Okay, we see Michael Reid get the ball in this situation. He takes a run forward the ball, but Minnesota picks it up. And they're trying to try to release the pressure. Venegas gets wide, great little cutback. And he finds Jamie Watson. Oh, Jamie Watson didn't come back to the ball. And now Atlanta comes after it again. Great recovery run by Jamie Watson. Back and helping defensively. And again, Atlanta gets the ball wide, crosses it in, and Minnesota heads it out. Atlanta sustains that pressure, keeps going at Minnesota. Changing direction of the ball, getting the ball wide. Back again, and then players have to close. Atlanta keeps moving in pressure. And a ball wide again, ball played across, and a great catch by Samuel to stop the pressure. Now he relaxes, gets his team pushing up the field. We'll look at a couple places where Minnesota could have played a little bit better defensively. Now Giuliano, he kind of dives in with his feet. We like the pressure, but we want more controlled pressure. But again, Aaron Pitchcole is recovering hard. Khalif steps in to help win the ball. Now we get four guys around that ball, made it really difficult for the forward to get control. And Kevin does a real great little move to take some of the pressure off. We see Miguel looking for space and a long ball out. We see Khalif in a good role here where he gets a ball. Giuliano's in a pretty good role too, if we can only get that ball through. But there's not many options for Kevin Vinnings. That's a tough ball from the play. It's on his left foot. He's coming inside with it. Tough to play the long ball to Miguel. Tough to even, he's got pitch in the way and the two Atlanta defenders in the way. So he chooses Jamie Watson. Jamie should be making a run back to the ball. The Atlanta player is going to run right by him for the ball and win the ball. If Jamie makes that run back, the Atlanta player doesn't get the ball. So Atlanta now is pressure again. Giuliano's got to get back. I'd like to see Khalif get back. We see players in the midfield are kind of open, and there's some good space for Atlanta to attack. Let's go back one more time. You notice Miguel Ybarra just kind of watching what's going on. You know he's hoping for the ball to break out. But once he doesn't get it, he knows he just, oh, darn, I didn't get the ball. What's going on? He should have seen me. That reaction has to be instantaneously when he sees that that ball is won, turn and sprint back. As we see the develop here, there are two players coming in on Justice Davis. Now Thiago is kind of ball watching too. Thiago doesn't need to be in that space with three guys around that player. Cristiano Diaz has to call Thiago back to cover the two players in the middle so Justin Davis can play the Y guy. So now we're caught in a 3-on-2 situation. So I'd say Thiago's a culprit. Miguel Ybarra, that's a really long sprint to get back in that spot. So really, Cristiano Diaz has to get Thiago back. Also, Khalif might have seen danger too and seen the fact that we were caught in a situation where it was a 3-on-2. Let's just watch the cross come in, see who's open. The wide player for Lanta, if that ball gets bumped on, he's all alone in that far post area. And just that hesitation can be very dangerous and could have led to an opportunity where Lanta could actually put the ball away and tie the game up. Fortunately, he was cleared out. And again, Lanta, again, wins the ball again. Khalif has to close quickly. Now they do find the wide player. Miguel is caught, pinched up a little tiny bit, and he's played a little defense now. When the ball gets played in, Miguel Ybarra should be going back toward Justin Davis, making sure the guy is visible on his left side. So Miguel should be able to see Xhaka with kind of his peripheral vision to the left and not be caught upfield like this. Because Xhaka now creates a good chance. Attacks the end line, gets a good cross in. Unfortunately, it's close enough to the goal for Samuel to wrap his hands around the ball, get good control, and give Minnesota a little breather defensively. Teams mature and they get better. And India, and as an entry team last year, struggled a bit. We're still very competitive, still a tough side to play against, but they just didn't have that little edge to get those goals, the timely goals, and win those games. This year, I think they have a little more edge. It's still not there yet. I still think they're coming along as an expansion franchise, but they are a good, solid team. They play well, they defend well, they'll attack well. All these things are going to be challenges for Minnesota in this match coming up. Okay, we see a game played in Indianapolis, a long ball played over the top. Cristiano Diaz gets a head on it, goes wide to Smart. Smart just gets a header down the line as Rugg makes a little bending run around the defender. And again, Pineda makes a run, one-touch crack near post, and a nice goal for Indiana. When you think about the defense for Minnesota in this situation, a good clearance by Diaz, I mean high, not perfect, but a little wide. A wonderful little run by Rugg, and Cristiano Diaz a little behind him, step behind, and he's still on side with the central defenders. Nice ball by Smart. Now, Cristiano Diaz wants to make, he should be a sprint to get out in front of the ball, to take away that outside run by Rugg on the end line. He just hesitates, gets a sprint out, he just caught in the side instead out in front of him. And Rugg just sees that little gap and makes a run along the end line. We see Kevin Manegas has good vision. We see Calvano looking over his shoulder to see another Indiana player coming in. But a couple of things that would be helpful in this situation. I'd like to see Giuliano making that sprint back for the D. Because right now, what's happening is that Diaz has been beaten. Calvano now probably has to go to the ball. Now, Kevin Manegas should be stepping in and seeing both the run of Pineda and probably the run of number 14 for Indiana. And if Giuliano had made a diagonal run back to the D, he could be helping out defend. If Kevin Manegas has moved out and stayed with Pineda, he could have blocked up this channel and we would have been able to bottle this shot up and not give him a chance. And Charlie Rugg was a key player to make things happen. And he was a thorn in defensive side when he joined Indy last year. And he's still a very effective player. In this next clip, we're going to be seeing an attack by Indy 11 against Carolina. And again, the same players. We'll see a nice run by Wojcik. He plays a beautiful chip over the top to Rugg. Rugg, almost in the same position, gets a good cross in, drives it across the box. The defender tries to cut it off and scores an own goal. But again, we see the situation that Minnesota has to defend well against this team. A couple of good situations here. We see the ball played in. A nice little diagonal run, well-timed run by Rugg. Gets in behind the defense. Defense recovers. Rugg looks up the end line. We see Mares making a run to the goal mouth. We see Garas in the far kind of far post area there. And Rugg just drives it across. The defender goes to cut off from getting the ball to Mares and just knocks in his own goal. As Minnesota goes to Indianapolis this coming weekend, they again have to keep that defensive intensity. They've been playing well defensively now for three games. Nice shutout victory over Atlanta last weekend. They have to continue to play that high-pressure defense. The work rate of Aaron Pitchcolin was great in that midfield. What a tireless worker. Greg Jordan came off the bench to help sort of close up the gaps and make it tougher for Atlanta to try to create chances. Those kind of things need to continue. And it has to be 11 players playing good defense. On attack, I imagine Coach Ligel will go with a similar attacking formation using Jamie Watson and Khalif Ali-Hassan and Miguel Ibarra. Their quickness, mobility. Hopefully Pablo, with the confidence he's gotten from these two goals in the last three games, will continue to perform well, which he has done now. The outside defenders, Justin Davis and Kevin Venegas, those two have to continue to look for ways to get their flanks and get crosses in to help create more chances for Minnesota. It'll probably take more than a goal, though, to win this game. My guess is it's going to end up a 2-1, 3-2 match. We'll see what turns out, and we're hoping it's in Minnesota's favor.